ask you, thank you for all the blessing that you have bestowed upon us. Ask you to lead us and guide us in making decisions for the best of our community, for the best of our state, for the best of the United States. Guide the prisoners and everybody tonight. Please bless the lives of Son Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Laura Bogo.
Ms. Joyce Porter.
Present.
Mr. Edward Gallman. Ms. Linda Chaney.
Present.
Mr. Willie Lee.
Here.
Ms. Virginia Bell.
Here.
Mr. Allison Travis. Four members present, two members absent, quorum present.
First item on the agenda, approval board minutes. Regular board meeting, August 9th, 2012. And special board meeting, August 16th, 2012.
I second.
Motion is second, have been received, vote.
Mr. Lee.
Yes.
Ms. Bell.
Yes.
Ms. Porter.
Yes.
Ms. Chaney.
Yes.
Four yeas, two absent, motion carried.
Item D, approved agenda, September 13th.
I move to approve.
Mr. Lee.
Yes.
Ms. Bell.
Yes.
Ms. Porter.
Yes.
Ms. Chaney.
Yes.
Four yeas, two absent, motion carried.
Item E, public comments, do not have any cards. Moving to item F, superintendent report.
Good evening, board. First, we'd like to recognize, we have two people that have passed, and we'd like to remember them. Ms. Betty Butler, retired math teacher from our high school, and Mr. Willie Eugene Smith Sr., a retired bus driver. So I'm asking everyone to please, let's give a moment of silence to these two people. Thank you. We'd like to start up our program again this school year for our employee and student of the month. And this month, we will begin that, starting with the elementary school. So I'm gonna ask Mr. Douglas if you would please come up and present his employee and student of the month for August.
Our teacher of the month is Mrs. Chandler. And let me start by saying that we all know that Ms. Chandler had some issues, some physical issues in her body this past school year. And Ms. Chandler has done one thing for me. She has showed me how a hero moves on. And I just want to tell Ms. Chandler, first of all, before we even talk about Teacher of the Month, I want to thank her for showing me how to press on in spite of facing challenges in her body. So she has been a great example for me and our entire staff on how to move on when you have some issues. So Ms. Chandler, I just want you to know you're my hero for that, all right? Now, next thing, I spoke with Ms. Chandler over the summer, and she told me this. We talked on the phone, and she said, I promise you this. She said, I promise that this coming school year, I am going to do a great job. And she had set out to do exactly what she said. First of all, with the issues that she's had in her body, she has not missed not one day of school. And that in itself is remarkable. After that, Ms. Chandler, whenever you go by her classroom, she is walking around her classroom teaching, and her kids are completely engaged all day. And I do mean her kids are engaged all day in her classroom. The next thing that has impressed me the most is Ms. Chandler's attitude. In every meeting that we've had, faculty meeting, it doesn't matter. Ms. Chandler has taken the time out to be the most engaged person in those meetings. And what she has done, she has made other people feel like it's okay to be that engaged. So she has been a great example for the people that are around her. And so for that reason, Ms. Chandler, I want to thank you for everything that you've done and congratulate you for being our Teacher of the Month at St. Helena Elementary School. Thank you so much.
Right.
Yes, ma'am.
And I'd like to thank Mr. Douglas for having such confidence in me. And I'm glad to be back, very much. My little student, I'm very hoarse. He couldn't come today. We thought the meeting was at 5:30. It was at 6, and his mother had to go to work. And I'm just proud of my little student, Lorenzo Robinson. He's a very good student, and I had a write-up on him, Ms. Superintendent. Joseph, if you could just read it.
My most favorite student. Lorenzo Robinson is my choice for the most favorite student in second grade in Ms. Chandler's classroom. Lorenzo is a very good reader and he remembers so much that he is learning each day. He makes me feel so great to be a teacher when I ask questions about the lesson and see how well he retains information. He raises his hand for everything I ask. Not only does Lorenzo listen and pays attention in the classroom, he is very well-rounded. When the class has talent shows in the classroom on break, he raps for us. He is a very good rapper. Lorenzo is facing a real good future. Lorenzo makes my day. He's a very excellent student. I think very highly of him. Keep up the good work, kid.
And thank you, Mr. Douglas. I'd like to thank my principal. He's been such an inspiration to me, too.
Yeah, look, thank you, sweetheart. I appreciate that. Thank you, Ms. Chandler.
All right, thank you. And I'd like to thank everybody.
Do you have any representation from the middle school?
I do. Our teacher of the month from St. Helens, first I would like to apologize to my principal. We have open house tonight at the middle school. That's why he's not here. So I just want to apologize for him. Also that our teacher of the month for St. Helens Middle School is Ms. Lacey Hearing. And Ms. Lacey is a new employee at St. Helens Middle School. And when she came on, Ms. Lacey is very energetic and she loves the kids, and I have not seen anything that Ms. Lacey have not done besides go beyond and above the call of duty. Ms. Lacey Henry is our middle school teacher of the month. And our student of the month is Ms. Darinae Griffin. She's a 4.0 student and she's a seventh grade student at St. Helens Middle School.
I don't have much to say, but I feel kind of obligated to say something. I really do love my kids as much as they try me every single day. I love them to death, so that's why I still wake up every morning at 5 o'clock to drive an hour to get there and see their faces, even if they don't want to see mine. And I mean, it's people like Ms. Porter who know everybody and give me pointers like every single day.
Oh, thank you.
And our principals who came in with just as little resources and just as little preparation for their situation as we had. They came in last second and have been rocking it out in that front office since they stepped on campus. So for their support and for everything that they do, that's the only reason that I could ever do anything in my classroom successfully. So thank them the absolute most.
Now we'd like to recognize our employee and our student of the month from the high school. We have our new principal, Mr. Sullivan.
We're going to recognize Mr. Paula Jones, who's one of our custodians at the high school. I want to recognize Mr. Paul for going above and beyond the call of duty. Mr. Jones, during the hurricane, was at the school to open up, to service the Red Cross, to do everything he could possibly do to assist us in that venture. Mr. Jones is also on campus all the time, and every time you ask him to do something, 130% effort at all times. Not one thing that I've ever asked him to do that he is not willing to do, wanting to do, desires to do, and works every possible minute of the day to make sure that your request gets taken care of. So I want to recognize Mr. Paul Jones. Now, he was not able to be here tonight. He is working, so which is synonymous with him and what he does. So. Next, I would like to recognize, and this one gives me the highest pleasure of anything I've ever had to do in my life. This is the first time that I've actually had the opportunity to do this, so this is exciting to me. Mr. Datron Ivy Matthews is an 11th grade student at St. Helena Central High School. Mr. Matthews, first time he attempted his ACT, he made it 24.
Wow.
GPA 3.675. And on time, all the time. Incredible, wonderful young man. And I'm going to tell you a little bit more about him in just a second because there's some other stuff I need to tell you. It's just incredible. But he wants to be a mechanical engineer, so that's an exciting thing as well. But we do something every morning called a pump-up. After we go through an affirmation, we have a whole morning routine. But during our morning pump-up, we're really trying to instill energy and enthusiasm and engagement in our students, get them prepared for the day. And one of the things that we say and we talk about, of course, we do the daily affirmation, which talks about character values and those types of things. And then the daily pump-up, it's a great day at St. Helena High School, and I am a champion. And that's the way we finish that conversation in the morning time. But one of the things that we were having a little trouble with that group getting pumped up in the morning. And of his own free will, outside of everyone else in the building, outside of every other gentleman, young man that was on his side, Datron stepped forward and he led those young men. And when I say he led them, I'm on the gym floor and I can hear him above everybody else in the building, leading those young men in the daily affirmation about what type of character he is going to address. And when it got ready and time for him to speak about what type of day we were going to have at St. Helena High School and what we were when we walked through that day as champions, he was louder than anybody else, to the point that he inspired every young man in that group to join together with him in the following days to earn 2 free dress days because they outdid the girls in the competition for who was ready to go and who was on point for that day. And he led those young men that day. So I just want to recognize Mr. Datron Matthews as our student of the month.
Recognize our overall employee and student of the month, and this is sponsored by Taylor & Sons, so we are very fortunate to have them back again to present these awards to our illustrious employee and student. And for this month, the month of August, our employee of the month is Mr. Paul Jones.
Couldn't have done it without the help of the good Lord. Amen. I know you know that.
And our overall student of the month is Datron Matthews. And that concludes our presentation for our employee and student of the month. Our next item that I'd like to present to you all is our SETS accreditation update. As you all know, once again, we are going through our district accreditation, and we now have 5 weeks before our visit. Our visit will be October 21st, 22nd, and 23rd. And I spoke with the chairperson of the review team. Her name is Dr. Cheryl Allred, and she is from South Carolina, Mullen, South Carolina. We also have 4 other people on our team. We have Mr. Ray Poplis, who is with the Advanced Ed in Louisiana. So he is stationed in Baton Rouge at LSU. Then we have Mr. John Walker. He's a guidance counselor from Plaquemines Parish School System from Bell Chase. We have Ms. Janet Hyatt, retired director from Lafayette Parish School System from Lafayette, and Dr. Tim Gouin, principal at Russellville High School from Russellville, Alabama. So we have a great team that will be coming in and doing a very thorough walkthrough of all of our schools in our district. As a matter of fact, they will be spending 20 minutes in every classroom in our district. Mm. So for 2 days, they'll be in the classroom. So this is about how well our teachers instruct our students, how active and engaging those lessons are, and also how we operate our district. I've made it clear to my staff and teachers and everyone in St. Helena that we want to earn highly functional on every standard. This will bring a high level of distinction and honor to our parish, and it will show that we are truly committed to continuous improvement. Also knowing that the top districts in the state of Louisiana are district accredited. So we will be a part of that, illustrious group, and I'm very excited about that visit. So October 21st, 22nd, and 23rd, we will have our visit. We will be sending out postcards to everyone in the parish to make them aware that we are doing it, and we'll be preparing carefully for the next 5 weeks. Thank you. That concludes my presentation.
Hi, it's Virginia. First mayor report, Ms. Morgan.
Good afternoon. Our personnel report as of today, we have 7 new hires. Pre-K teacher Katie Beal, effective date August 20th, 2012. Kindergarten teacher Sandria Akaveri, effective September 5th, 2012. First grade teacher Megan Gibson, effective date September 13th, 2012. First grade Paula Sankular, effective 9/17/12. English Renetta London, effective August 22nd, 2012. Natalie Taylor, math high school teacher, August 8th, 2012. Science teacher at the high school, Matthew Doolittle, effective September 10th, 2012. We have 3 resignations, Sherry George, Stacey LaGuard, Angela Perkins. We have 1 transfer that's been approved, G. Lester Holmes from journalist to career teacher at the high school to physical education. And that's the end of my report.
Motion.
Second.
I'm moving to accept that report.
Motion and second have been received. Vote.
Mr. Lee?
Yes.
Ms. Bell?
Yes.
Ms. Porter?
Yes.
Ms. Chambers?
Yes.
48, 2 absent, motion carries. Item H, budget finance report, Ms. Holly.
Thank you. I received your budgets. I just wanted to point out that the efficiency for the year is only going to be $297,967. If there's any questions, we've got time to look over it. We have to finish the year with a fund balance of $905,000.
We still have almost $700,000 in the Gulf Coast Recovery Grant for
2012.
That grant ends at the end of September, at the end of this month. So
this month?
Yes, ma'am. So we are working real hard with Gulfer to make sure that, you know, the remaining balance will be used to renovate the technical college. Matter of fact, today we had a meeting to look at the specifics for the cafeteria. So all of that is at play, and the monies have got to be encumbered. before the date, so.
Okay, we don't need to ask for an extension on that?
We're asking for an extension to just make sure that we're within the time. We have a significant decrease in 1 year from 1.5 million to just down to 297. So we're still not out of clear, but, and still have more to cut, but we're in a better financial situation than we were a year ago.
And we're still functioning as a school system.
Yes.
So that's fantastic. Congratulations on that.
Motion.
I move on.
Motion and second. Vote.
Mr. Lee?
Yes.
Ms. Bell? Ms. Porter?
Yes.
Ms. Chambers?
Yes.
Four yeas, two absent. Motion carried.
Item I, policy report.
Ms. Stone? Actually, that's not.
We brought to committee, good evening. We brought to committee the special education policy handbook, which just makes sure that we're implementing everything in the Individuals with Disabilities Education Act and in Bulletin 1706. So this is just all the regulations that we must follow in the department.
Were there not a lot of changes in that, or that I was missing something? It looked like significant changes. Was that not
Not any major. I mean, there's always changes every year.
Nothing major.
Yeah,
no, just major.
Right. Just all basically major. Just taken straight from policy.
Ms. Bell, I think she's being very modest. The significant change that took place in the special education department is that now everything is streamlined. She was able to take all of the policies that really were scattered and pull them together and streamline them all. And then also give the teachers the procedures that's necessary in order to follow those policies and place them in a nice binder for them that's just at their fingertips. So this was a huge undertaking that Dr. Guidry took on. So yes, while the changes in the policies may not have been major, the changes in how we function in special education has been a major change. So I have to applaud Dr. Guidry for doing that wonderful job.
And then our special ed teachers are going to be better.
Special education teachers are more aware and more prepared and have the tools that they need at their fingertips, whereas before it was not.
Now they have that.
Yes, every teacher has the teacher version of this, which gives them actually the procedures that go along with the policy.
Right, and so now when you get updates, all they got to do is just take all the pages.
Right.
Good, that's good.
Thank you.
Motion.
Thank you.
Motion and second. We receive. Vote.
Ms. Lee?
Yes.
Ms. Bell?
Yes.
Ms. Porter?
Yes.
Ms. Chambers?
Yes.
Four yeas, two absent. Motion carried.
We are on Monday meeting compliant with the budget being advertised. It should be up past 10 days, 9. But everything was delayed because of the hurricane.
We just wanted to make that point that we tried our best to be in compliance and we're just off by a day. And it's because of the natural disaster with Hurricane Isaac. But everything else is in compliance and of just that one day. So I just want to make the board aware of that.
They allow for things.
I'm sure they allow for things like that, but yes, we like to make sure that regardless, you know, we're like the mail, rain, snow, sleet, hail. We want to make sure that we're following, we're compliant. But we just want to make it known and just be transparent that we are one day off and it's not anything that we did, it's because of the storm.
That's our motion.
Second.
Motion and second. I perceive that we adjourn.
Ms. Lee?
Yes.
Ms. Bell?
Yes.
Ms. Porter?
Yes.
Ms. Chambers?
Yes.
4 years, motion carried.